Hi, this is David Papkin, TSI Consulting Services. Welcome back to Implementing Microsoft Azure. In this video demo, it's implementing web apps. So the first thing I'm going to do is creating web apps. I'm going to create a web app and a deployment slot and then configure deployment credentials. So I'm going to say new. I'm going to go to web app. Web and mobile, right here. We'll click on web app. I'm going to put in your name. It has to be a unique name, so I'm going to put in this web app and this right here. And the new resource group I'm going to do. And the location one in this. I'm going to create new. You pick the location versus new name. Price and TRS one standard. Select. Okay. And create. Okay, so good. The deployment succeeded on this right here. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a deployment slot. And add a deployment slot. Browse app services. I'm going to use this web app I created. Now under settings in the publishing area right here, I'm going to click on deployment slots right here. We add a slot. Name, staging. And this one right here. The configuration, I'm going to select the web app that I created. First task, OK. And then I'll add the new deployment slot to the list. So what I'm going to do is close the deployment slot. And I'm going to open up my PowerShell. I got to put the name in. I here. I think the admin made zero. And the password is on here. I'm going to save. Close this. Here, I'm going to, next thing I'm going to do is obtain a publishing profile. Here. I'm going to click on Get Publishing Profile right here. Right here. Save. Visual Studio. Open it. Debug. I'm going to start debugging. I gave them under this one. I'm going to learn more. Contact. I'm going to close it in the Explorer. Thing I'm going to do is deploy a web app. Stop debugging. I'm going to click on their data website. I'm going to publish it. And report. And let's go over here. Let's find the dot publishing file. Click on this publishing file on this. Open it. Okay. Audit the connection to it. Visual Studio will then connect to the Azure web app. If it's valid, a green tick mark will appear. Next. This, next, this, start preview. And these are all the list of changes to the web app we're going to have right here. Publish. So this will be the new web app hosted in Azure, right here. Notice that one has mine web app URL. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to close Visual Studio. For completing this, I've deployed a web app hosted in Azure that I can open with any common browser. Next thing I'm going to do is managing web apps. I'm going to deploy a web app for staging. So I'm going to click on the web app here. Publishing area here. Notice that as it loaded, more and more things appeared in this publishing one, so you just had to maybe wait a little bit. I'm going to click on the deployment slots. I'm going to click the staging one. It's created. This one's staging one. I'm going to get published profile. Save. Open this. Publish this right here. Same right here. So I'm going to click on import, browse. I'm going to find that publishing setting one right here. Say okay. I'm going to validate the connection. Good, validate the connection next. Make sure it's on release. Next. We can start preview. These are the file modifications to be made. Publish it. So here's the new one, the new web app in the staging slot. Web app dash staging. Next thing I'm going to do is, swap deployment slots. And on this one right here, under Essentials, this is the URL. Now notice the color scheme hasn't changed on this one right here. So I'm going to close this one right here. Publish some settings here. Deployment slot. I'm going to swap it right here. Swap. Sources staging. Destination is production. Okay. Good. Now notice the color of this has changed back to the original one, to the old, the color scheme's reverted to the old scheme. So now I've rolled it back right there. So the next thing I'm going to do is implement Traffic Manager. I'm going to deploy a web app to another region. And the location on this one right here is Southeast Asia. And I want to find some other locations. This one right here. So let's just see. So get a zero location. I'm going to try Central US for a location here. I'm going to set a Azure region. This is going to be the second location. If it likes this one right here. Good. So now I'm going to create a new web app with Datum Lab Web Resource Group 2, and this is the new one. It's similar to the other, except let's see if this works. This new one creating, this new web app. Great, as you can see, this new one here, this new web app was created. Okay, let me just look for it, browse, app services. So now I'm going to do is this. I'm going to make a second web app. Web app 2. That I've created this one here, the second web app 2. This one right here, and this is Central US, my second location on here. Look at app services. And the app services right here. Good, so that's the new web app. Good, I'm going to close that. Now this one right here, I'm going to create a traffic manager profile. And this one right there. Good. So I'm going to get this new traffic manager profile. Right here. Good performance is zero pass right here. Here, this one. Here, this one. Good. And the next thing to do is I'm going to add endpoints and configure traffic manager right here. So right here. Browse and I can just do this one. Traffic manager profile. Endpoints. Add endpoints. I'm going to type in the name of the two web apps I have here. App service, choose an app service, web app to web app, good. Web app to app service. To say okay. Okay, great. So I've created this two endpoints. Make sure change the DNS to 30. Save it. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to test it. Traffic manager right here. Now I'm going to test this. Let's see what it does. Great. Brings us up. Fantastic. I'm going to try to do this. That should be in this right here. Now I'm going to do is take a look here. I believe it's this one. Web app. I'm going to edit it and disable it. Save. Okay. Now this one, let's see, it's 20 seconds. One. Let me count to 20 seconds. Now I waited 20 seconds because that was the DNS timeout that we put in there. So notice now that it's showing the other one. The other endpoint, because we disabled web app. Now I'm going to try this for a little extra. Let's see if that still works. See? And you can still come into that one. But I'm using the other web app one right there. Thank you.